I wonder, what is conservation?
Oh, hi, I'm Kaden. Welcome to Smithsonian's National Zoo and Conservation Biology Institute, where I've been wondering, what is conservation? It's even in the name of our zoo. So what is it, and why does it have to do with animals? Let's go explore the zoo and find out. Come on. So what does conservation mean? I hear the word conserve in conservation, and conserve means to protect from harm. Animal conservation means to protect animals from harm. Many wild animals are threatened by actions like cutting down forests or polluting waterways that are very harmful for their homes. Scientists and other zoo staff work really hard to conserve and protect wildlife from these harmful actions. So let's go take a look at some different animals around the zoo that have been helped by conservation. Do you recognize this animal? It's a black-footed ferret. Their home in the wild is the American Great Plains, where their favorite food, the prairie dog, lives. Because of habitat loss and disease, the black-footed ferret population went so low that they are thought to be extinct, meaning none left. But luckily, they weren't. Scientists collected the last 18 individuals in the wild to help conserve them. Zoo scientists gave them a safe place to breed and raise their babies called kits. Over 1,000 black-footed ferrets have been born at Smithsonian Conservation Biology Institute. That's a lot of ferrets. Now, once those ferrets reach adulthood, they're released back to the wild, back to their native prairie habitat in places like Wyoming, South Dakota, and Colorado. Thanks to these actions, there are now more black-footed ferrets living in the wild. That's conservation in action. Let's go find another animal that has been helped by conservation. What's black and white and saved by conservation? I bet you know it's an animal. Which one? A giant panda. Giant panda conservation happens in the wild and at the zoo. Here at the zoo, animal keepers, veterinarians, researchers, and scientists all work together to give giant pandas amazing care so they can live here, breed, and raise their young. In the wild, scientists at the zoo and China are working to protect bamboo forests. Bamboo forests are cut down to clear the land for farmland or collect bamboo for building things. That leaves the giant pandas with smaller areas of habitat, so they have less food and less shelter. So scientists are working together to build up these bamboo forests and plant more bamboo to create paths or corridors where the giant pandas can make their way from one habitat to another. Now, by conserving the bamboo, this gives giant pandas more food and shelter they need to survive. Conservation is so important to protect the animals we love. Zoos work to conserve animals near and far to protect them and their habitats for future generations. Scientists also research animals to learn more about their needs and figure out the best ways to save them. You can learn more about animals' needs by observing animals whenever you see them. There are so many animals that have been helped by conservation efforts, like the American bison, the American alligator, and the whooping crane. What animals do you love? What can you do to help conserve them? So what can we do to conserve animals? Are there things you can think of to be a conservationist? There are little actions we can take all the time that will help
with animal conservation. Here are a couple to get you started. One thing you can do is use less paper. Paper comes from trees, and trees make up a habitat of many different animals. So using less paper saves trees and animal habitat all over. Another way to use less paper is use an air dryer in the bathroom to dry your hands instead of paper towels. And finally, when you're using paper, choose recycled paper. And when you're done with it, toss it in the recycling bin and recycle it yourself so it becomes new paper once again. Those are all ways to help and easy actions we can all take to be conservationists. Wow, that was a great question to explore and answer together. Thanks for helping with conservation and for wondering, exploring, and learning with me. Stay curious, and I'll see you next time.